Hi, it's Jennifer from Soul Source Tarot, and I'm here to do your new moon reading. So this is for the new moon in Aries on March 24th. So timing for, you know, these readings, even a new moon or a full moon is the same, okay? The timing is fluid. You know, energies can last you know, before the new moon, they can start before the new moon, and they can go out 6 months. I mean, they can go out, the timing is universal. So, but this is intended for right around the new moon. Okay. So March 24th. So it could be happening anywhere, you know, from, you know, I feel like it's like a few days before to a few days after, but new moons are about setting intentions. Okay. It's when you set an intention for something. So during this new moon, say you're watching this a week before or whatever, keep in mind that right around, and I'd say mostly for me, what I have learned is like 2 days before is when you want to, that's when it's very potent for manifesting. That's just my own opinion. That's the way I feel. Anyhow, so I feel like 2 days before you start this manifestation, you get a piece of paper out and you write down your intentions. And 6 months from now, you will be shocked at what you have manifested based on your belief. Okay. You have to believe in it. Okay. You have to, but you can't manifest something that you don't really want. I mean, yeah, you can't manifest something that you don't really want, but you can't manifest something that somebody else doesn't want, you know. So if you can't force somebody, so you can't write down the piece of paper, a person's name. Okay. It doesn't work like that. You have to surrender. Part of setting intentions and manifesting is surrendering to the divine. Okay. Surrendering to the higher power and having faith and believing that they are going to bring you your wish fulfillment based on your intentions, but you can't control it. Okay. Yes. Free will plays a part, but you can't, the universe is really in control. Yes. You are in control of, you know, the worldly, energy, your life at this point, your life at this time, you're in charge of yourself, but the universe or the higher power has some sort of say per se. So you have to surrender to the divine will, to the divine. So anyway, my suggestion is to start the manifestation process now, writing down on that piece of paper, because when you write things down, it becomes real, but don't put a name on it, because you know, you can't say, I want so-and-so to love me, or you know, I'm married to this person, because then you're just going to be disappointed, because perhaps that other person doesn't feel the same way about you. Okay. You have to surrender. You have to surrender. You have to surrender to the divine. So anyhow, I don't know why I had to tell you all that, but perhaps this new moon is about surrendering. So what do we got? What do we have? We're going to start with one of these. Maybe it's about surrendering and setting intentions. Now you got to think about Aries, and I love Aries, obviously. Aries is all about control and needing to have structure, needing to have organization, wanting things structured and organized. But if you think about the Emperor in reverse, that is somebody who is clinging to control, somebody that refuses to let go of control, somebody that has a big ego and is under a lot of social pressure. So perhaps, you know, it's about letting go of that ego and surrendering. That's what it's about, obviously, because I really want to reiterate that fact so much. So what do we have for this new moon? The Fool. And this card happens to be represented by Aries, so, which is interesting. So this is a fresh start, a new beginning, taking risks. Doing things you've never done before, letting go of fear. It's like you have an opportunity to start on a new chapter, a new journey. This is the beginning of a new life. It is. A new phase is about to begin. But you are being called to just do it. Just do it. So there's a feeling of, you know, excitement. It's an exciting time for new beginnings. But with the Fool, you have to leave everything else behind. Okay, you're starting a new chapter. You're starting a new journey. On this new journey, you're not taking that baggage with you of the past. That baggage is staying. It's not coming. So this is starting with a clean slate. This is exciting. Looks fun. Now I see the butterfly. Transformation. So we have a transformation that has happened, or it's happening right now. So this is starting from zero, starting from scratch. We got a couple. I just want one, please. This is like painting a new picture. Being your own, you know, you're the illustrator of your life. You get to choose what you want it to look like. Okay? You get to choose. Sorry, I gotta stop for 1 second. I'm sorry, I just need to, I'm sorry. I have to ask them to turn something down. I can hear stuff in the background, so I was just letting somebody know. This is the illustrator, being the illustrator of your own life. Painting that picture as you want it. You get to choose. You paint the picture on that piece of paper. You decide what you want your life to look like. One card, please. Trust yourself. Trust. This is about believing in yourself, trusting yourself. We're going to read this one. You know, having faith in yourself, listening to your mind. Maybe we won't read it. We're listening to your gut, listening to your intuition, doing what you know that you need to do. There's obviously something that you have to leave behind, because that Fool card wouldn't be here. There's some sort of baggage, something that needs to go. This is like decluttering as well. I feel like you're building a new foundation. You have the opportunity to build a new foundation. You know, it's like, you know, you deep down inside, you know that there's something that you need to do. And I need to tell you that you need to listen to your gut. Those little nudges, those little pokes, those constant thoughts that you are getting that are plaguing you, that is a higher power saying, why aren't you doing this? Why aren't you following your heart? Why aren't you doing what is best for you? It's time for your new life. It's time for you to do what you have imagined. It's time for you to go for it. So what do we have for this new moon, the 24th, starting with a clean slate, painting a beautiful picture, painting a new picture, the grass is green, the water is blue, there's a rainbow, rainbows are, you know, this difficulty is over. Planting new seeds, traveling, going someplace else. This is exciting. somebody may be moving. Their gut is telling them, somebody's gut is telling them that it's time to start over. It's time to go someplace else. It's time to write that new story. That's like, write the new story. It's funny that I said, get out that piece of paper. Maybe somebody needs to write a book. I don't know. But this is about writing that new story that you have been thinking about. King of Pentacles reversed. King of Pentacles reversed. So this is somebody that is unstable, insecure, lazy, focuses too much on their money, focuses too much on everything but love. The King of Pentacles in reversed is not focused on love, okay? This guy could be a gambler, could be selfish, greedy, stubborn, could be a miser. This person makes poor decisions, poor financial decisions. Very much focused on money, okay? He's focused on money, focused on everything but love. Not very grounded. Somebody that very egotistical. We have an egotistical individual here. Temperance. It's time to find balance. This is somebody that is unbalanced right here. You know, you need to be able to balance out work and or money and everything else in your life. Now we have an offering of some sort, blending, cooperating, mingling, getting together, working together. A healing. So this is a healing of some sort on this card. Being blessed. Somebody is being given a blessing of some sort. Somebody is being given a blessing. But we have this very stubborn individual here who is very egotistical. So this person may not see that there's an opportunity for a blessing because they're so focused on all the wrong things. We have somebody here that is focused on all the wrong things. And this is a card of allow and accept change. So a very stubborn individual that is not evolving, okay? And it's time to evolve. This is about evolving. This is about harmony and flow and change. A need to be grounded, but also fluid. So we have somebody here that is so stubborn, so set in their ways, that they need to be more fluid. They need to be more open to change. There's such a wonderful possibility here. Ten of Wands. Now, this is Ten of Wands reverse. This is making a conscious change. So we do have somebody here that has been very stubborn and egotistical and set in their ways that is being given an opportunity, which is an absolute blessing, to change. To change. So this is letting go of the baggage again, crawling out of this deep, dark hole. This is a wonderful opportunity. The Temperance card is also about a lesson. It's the journey of life. It's where somebody has learned a lesson. It's not about money. It's not about things. It's more about feelings. You know, heartfelt feelings. We have somebody here that is needing to manage their feelings. They're needing to manage their feelings a little bit better. They've been overwhelmed and feeling like they were in a deep, dark place, but unwilling to evolve, unwilling to accept, unwilling to, you know, everything changes. Things change for a reason. This is a kind of purpose and reason. You know, if everything stays the same, then you're never gonna... I mean, everything stays the same. How fun is that? How exciting is that? That's boring. And this is very boring. That's boring. We change with every life experience, with every situation that brings us to our knees. This is about letting go. Ten of Wands reversed. That is letting go. Balance awaits with both of these cards. So it's like finding balance instead of, you know, staying down. You know, it's time to go back up. So anyway, the World. Now, the World card is a new beginning. Endings, the chapter, okay, from the Fool to the World. This is a chapter, a phase of your life that is coming to an end. Somebody had a lesson to learn. They did. The Temperance card comes after the Death card. Something has ended. It has. Something has ended, and it ended for a reason. Somebody needs to let it go. Let go of what? Surrender, please. It's funny that I started this reading out the way that I did. You can't, don't hold on to something that doesn't want you. It's time for your new life. This is a new you. This is a new life. This is a new beginning. One phase, one chapter of your life is over. Now, this is about total balance and being in the flow again. It's about leaving the past behind and traveling and moving towards the future. This is freedom. We have freedom here and freedom here. So freedom. Freedom to paint a new picture. Freedom to start over. Freedom for this new life. So we have a new beginning here. A lesson. Somebody has been taught something. Okay? They have been taught something. They have learned a lesson, which has changed them. This lesson has to do with superficiality. Lesson has been learned. The hanged man. We have somebody here that has been struggling. They have been struggling. Maybe they were punishing somebody. This is refusing to learn a lesson. This is about letting it go, letting something go. We have somebody who's been trying to punish. Maybe they've been punishing themselves, trying to prove something. Needing to have a new perspective, needing to surrender. You must struggle through whatever it is that you have been hanging on to and let it go. There's a new life, there's a new world, there's a new beginning here waiting for you to draw it up. Somebody's been wasting time, wasting a lot of time, thinking about what has happened, being very, very, very stubborn. We have a very stubborn individual, stubborn as hell. Learning a lesson for sure. We have somebody that has been learning a lesson about life. I feel like this person... somebody's been going through a period of enlightenment, and they've been struggling very, very, very hard. Struggling very hard. Thinking about what has happened. Thinking about, you know, who they are, who they have become. We have somebody here that has changed. They have changed. They have. They do have somebody here that has changed. They're not the same person that they used to be. Eight of Cups. Now, this is walking away from something. Somebody has learned that they need to walk away. They need to walk away from people that are sneaky. This person looks very sneaky. No, I don't want to have anything to do with it. Walk away. This is a lesson that needs to be learned. Learning to walk away from people that have their own motive, that don't support you, that don't make you happy. S- somebody is saying, nope, I don't want this anymore. Maybe that's the message. No, you don't make me happy. No. This is breaking free. This is freedom. And this is too. Somebody may be walking away. They've been in a deep hole. They've been in a dark place. But they've something has changed them. It's like they get some sort of enlightenment. Somebody has wasted a lot of time. The sun in a very sun reversed, unhappy situation. We have a unhappy situation here that somebody has been hanging on to. They have. They've been hanging on to it because they didn't want to struggle through the pain of letting it go. Because their ego was so big. Big ego here. This is ego and this is ego. We have ego. This is egotism. This one is too. So we have somebody here that has a huge ego that has learned a lesson about life. Or they're learning one. And they've changed. Something has changed this person. Perhaps somebody walking away from them has changed them, has enlightened them. Now there's definitely an element of unhappiness with that sun card reversed. There's sadness, false impressions. Somebody is not being honest with themselves. They're not being honest with themselves about what their heart wants. And it's like the universe, because the world is a universe card, is saying, here's your opportunity. Here's your opportunity to start fresh, to paint that new picture and to start over. But you're gonna have to walk away from whatever it is and stop clinging to control. It's time to wake up. It's time to follow your gut. When you follow your gut, we will give you this beautiful opportunity. Leave behind what isn't making you happy. That's killing you. You can't keep lying to yourself. So there's an opportunity for peace. There's an opportunity for harmony with that Temperance card. But there's also a need to be patient and to be real with yourself. Because we have somebody here that has not been being real. They haven't been real. They haven't been. And they've been struggling to, you know, take this new adventure that they're dreaming about. You're going to have to let go of your ego and step into new territory and take a risk. Taking a risk will lead to something beautiful, where the grass is greener. So I feel this new moon is about surrendering and letting go and starting down a new path. I think there's a new opportunity because the Fool is a new beginning. This new beginning comes after you release. It comes after you release something that has been weighing you down. The Ten of Wands reverse. It's been weighing you down. And this is letting go of baggage as well. Somebody has been weighed down by something that doesn't make them happy. Sun reversed. And it's walking away from that unhappy situation, Eight of Cups. Somebody is walking away. They may be moving. They could be moving here, like moving away. Traveling and moving. Somebody has been hanging on for way too long. And you know why? Because it was comfortable, but it wasn't happy. We're gonna read this card. So it's about moving on from something, following your heart, following your gut. Trust yourself. You are wise. You know how to grow even without knowing how you know. like the ancient forests, spectacular galaxies, and the acorn that becomes the oak, there's a natural intelligence for growth that is beyond logic and reason. It just happens, and the temperance is about growth as well. At the deepest levels, we are governed by this force that is so palpable, it literally shapes the world. At the same time, it is so invisible that sometimes we forget its presence and worry that our minds have to work everything out for life to happen and for us to be all right. We can become unnecessarily anxious about our affairs and how life will unfold. This oracle brings the message that you are growing. You really are. Don't doubt it. Even if you didn't see it yet, remember that so much is happening when the seed is still unbroken in the ground. Below the earth, it is summoning up all the might, power, and force it needs to push above the topsoil and burst up into the light. It is essential for anything good to happen later on. Yet, we don't see any of that. We have to trust that things will happen when the time is right. You are also being asked to trust in yourself. You know how to grow. Don't overthink things. It won't help you. Don't worry so much. You are doing a great job in this game of life. When you trust yourself, you relax and you can heed your own wisdom, insight, and messages much more clearly and easily. You have a big destiny this lifetime and much to experience. Sometimes you make the error of judging something that is unpleasant as negative or a mistake. It isn't. It's a lesson. It's just part of your great hunger for experience. It doesn't mean that you have a lot of it, but when you do, don't shame yourself for it. Simply let it be. Maybe it's just fertilizer for your next step on the path. It's all part of your life process, and it's all a sign of growth. Instead, choose to flow and grow. So this is about growth, and it is. It really is about growth. Somebody has grown in to a different person. It's time to allow and accept change. If you're not the same person that you used to be, you have to let go of where you were and step into new territory. You know, don't be afraid of new things. This is a new opportunity to start a new life. But you gotta let go of that fear and take this risk. So there is going to be a new beginning that is risky. My advice is to take it. Good luck.